Broken is the land, broken is the land, oh, I believe. The sinner, what we've just experienced right now, is just a foretaste of what the saints in the glory will experience in the presence of the Father, worshiping Him.
Hallelujah.
Day and night.
Hallelujah.
This is just a foretaste. If we are not used to, hallelujah, worshiping Him here, you will be out of place in heaven. You will be bored. You will be annoyed. Heaven will not be your destination, your final place. Practice the presence of the living God right now. Worship Him out of the abundance of your heart. He holds the world together in His hands. But for the sinner, I've got some good news for you tonight or this afternoon. You can change your ways. But if you don't change your ways, I don't have good news for you, sinner, because this is the only time we have. This is the only moment we have. Once we cross paths, that's the separating line, that's it. There is no remedy. There is no appeal where I would say, okay, let me miss this moment, but appeal when we get to the other side. It won't be. The book clearly says, this is the day of salvation. Not tomorrow, this is the day of salvation. So we can change our ways today if our ways are not changed yet. And Jesus is going to speak to us. Do not marvel, verse 28, John 5. Do not marvel at this, for the hour is coming in which all who are in the graves will hear His voice and come forth, those who have done good to the resurrection of life, and those who have done evil to the resurrection of what?
Damnation.
We have two groups here.
Hallelujah.
God bless the reading of His word.
Yes.
Father, I just want to yield myself to the Holy Spirit. We've been preparing hard. Lord Jesus, one voice working so hard throughout the night in order to create this atmosphere. Father God, we just want to let the Holy Spirit take over this afternoon for your glory.
Yes.
In Jesus' mighty name. And we say amen.
Amen.
You may take your seat. It won't be long. I know some of us may be dashing out because you have some appointments. And we understand that two groups that we have right before us. Those who will come out in the resurrection, praise God, for life. And those who are heading straight away to perdition, to condemnation. And the Bible speaks of eternal condemnation. Everlasting punishment, fire, or the lake of fire. Two groups, hallelujah. One group going to heaven, one group going to hell. Praise God. Where are you going, my brother? Where is your destination? Where are you heading to? Praise be to God. Because a time will come when the final sermon will be heard, and somebody would have sealed their eternal destination and doom, never to come back. The time is come, hallelujah, when the Lamb will stand in front of all the world and pass judgment, the Lamb of God. As I was praying, as I was searching these scriptures and going through the Bible, of course we are still looking into this very important Gospel of John, revealing great insight of what is the deity of Jesus, the nature of Jesus, and showing us that He was not just a man, but He was also God Himself. In the beginning was the Word. The Word was with God, and the Word was God. The Word was made flesh and dwelt among us. The Bible clearly says, in Him was grace. Hallelujah. In Him was full of truth, praise be to God. And this portion of His grace and truth, He has unloaded, He has given to each and every one of us.
Amen.
Praise be to God. The same God came, and the Bible says, and to them who receive Him, gave He the power to become sons and daughters of God. If you receive Him today, if you accept Him today, your heaven.
Amen.
And the Bible says that I will not lose anyone who has accepted me. God cannot lose those who come to him. Your decision today to accept Christ in a little church like this, in a little gathering like this, matters a great deal. The things that you are about to talk about, my brother, hallelujah, they are not just a mere abstraction. They are not just dreams that, hallelujah, our forefathers told us about when we were kids, about heaven. This is the real, the reality of what is coming right before us. That you shouldn't even trade the great eternal salvation that is coming to those who have accepted Christ for a little temporary earthly pleasure. Praise be to God. Let's go. Oh, I feel his embrace. Your eternal destination is determined by the choice that you make today. Amen. Praise God. Oh, my brother. Amen. I feel that time has come to shake ourselves. Time has come to wake up from our sleep. Time has come to shake. Humanity. Time has come to change the way we understand what it is to worship Him. Time has come to change our understanding of prayer. Hallelujah. Time has come, my brother, to stop, hallelujah, what is holding me by my side. That I want to go forward, but something keeps holding me. Hey, that God has given us to change our path. to change our future, to change our eternal destination. Drop down and die, but I'm not going Matthew 25 clearly tells us, then he will also say to those on the left, depart from me, you cursed, into the everlasting fire, prepared for the devil and his angels.
Amen.
He will separate people.
Yes, sir.
Jesus speaking himself.
Yes.
That they will go straight into the everlasting fire.
Yes.
Prepared. Amen. For the devil and all his angels.
Right.
In the last day.
Right.
Revelation 20 tells us the devil who deceived them was cast into the lake of fire and brimstone where the beast and the false prophet are, and they will be tormented day and night forever and ever. Amen. Brother, torment is coming. Torment is coming. The people will be tormented, those who have rejected our God, those who have turned their back on the grace given to them. Oh, praise be to God. Don't worry, our brothers had to go because they've got an appointment and they've already told me. Amen. In Jude chapter 7, has Sodom and Gomorrah and the cities around them in a similar manner to this, having given themselves over to sexual immorality and gone after strange flesh, as set forth as an example, suffering the vengeance of eternal life. Now watch what is coming here. When the fire of Sodom and Gomorrah fell, God says, he sent angels to warn them of what was coming.
Amen.
Amen. And God came not just to destroy, but to warn first. To warn first. Come out. Come out. Come out. Fire is coming. Destruction is coming. Amen. Leave. But what did the people do? Let's carry on. Let's forget the warning. They disregarded God's warning completely. Amen. And look what happened. The Bible says, as it was in the days of Lot. How many people were saved in the days of Lot? Three. In the days of Noah, eight. Thank you. Showing as it was in the days of Lot, as it was in the day of Noah, so shall it be. The Bible says, Jesus Christ declared, heaven and earth will pass away. Heaven and earth will pass away. But my word shall not pass away. Oh, praise be to God. Today, my brother, you can change your destination. Revelation chapter 20 tells us, verse 11, then I saw, amen, a great white throne, and him who sat on it, from whose face the earth and the heaven fled away, there was found no place for them. And I saw the dead, small grave, standing before God, and books were opened, and another book was opened, which is the book of life, and the dead were judged according to the works by the things which were written in the book. So God is going to judge the world by the things that are written in a specific book. Amen. The thing about the dead who are in it. Death and Hades delivered up the dead who are in it. And they were judged, each one, according to his works. Then death and Hades were cast into the lake of fire. This is the second death. And anyone not found written in the book of life was cast into the lake of fire. That's the final judgment. Now, I'm going to show you Jesus Christ in Luke chapter 16, speaking of something, amen, great theologians argued about. Some say it was a parable.
Yeah.
But in fact, it wasn't a parable. It was a reality of something
life, when we cross the mortal, amen, into immortality. Oh, Jesus, what a mighty God we serve. Let's open our Bible in Luke chapter 16. Let's read it calmly, because religion today is preaching, hallelujah, come to church, you will get a special blessing. Amen. No wonder many churches today are preaching, hallelujah, come to church, God is going to pour some blessings on you. Come to church, amen, your old covenant is going to be broken. Come to church, we will speak a special word over your life. And now people are fair falling into the trap of the enemy, and they are settling down for the earthly, and their mind is distracted. They can't see what is coming. So people are just happy for a little temporary blessing, a little earthly blessing, and missing out the eternal, which cannot be taken. Let's read it. Luke chapter 16. Hallelujah. Jesus is going to speak about something here that's shook a lot of people in their doctrine, in their religion. Oh, praise be to God. Amen. I'm going to just find it here. Praise God on the heights. The Bible says, verse 38. Sorry, Luke 16. Yeah, let's go. Sorry, verse 28. Praise God. Let's go. Verse 19 first. There was a certain rich man who was clothed in purple and fine linen and fare sumptuously every day. Listen to this part here. The Bible doesn't say, and he gave a parable. But the Bible said, there was a certain rich man. So the case, this scenario is real. It happened. But there was also a certain beggar named Lazarus, full of sores, who was laid at his gate, desiring to be fed with the crumbs which fell from the rich man's table. Moreover, the dogs came and licked his sores. So it was that the beggar died and was carried by the angels to Abraham's bosom. But what happened to the rich man? The rich man also died and was buried. He was not carried to Abraham's bosom. It's Abraham's bosom is a Bible way of saying paradise. Place of blessing. He was buried. Buried here is the type of what we call Hades or Sheol or the grave. We're not talking about the eternal destination, which is, what is the word? Gehenna? Not yet. Because that will come at the final judgment. So if you die now, there are things, amen, the Bible says, are happening to those who are unbelievers right now. They go to a place of torment, waiting for the final judgment. And this scripture is so wonderful. Let's read on. So it was, the wolf died, verse 23, and being in torment, in Hades, he lifted up his eyes and saw Abraham afar off and Lazarus in his bosom. What is he going to do? Then he cried and said, Father Abraham, have mercy on me. So he is sensible, even in death. The Bible says he's talking, crying out for mercy. Where? On the other side. So when you die, amen, that is not the end.
So it depends on how you die and where you're going. He is talking. Have mercy. Let's read on. And Saint Lazarus, that he might dip the tip of his finger in water and cool my tongue. He's thirsty on the other side. Torment. Amen. That's what the Bible says. And the next part says, but Abraham, he was so to cool my tongue, for I am tormented in this flame, in this flame. So he is being tormented in the other side. This is the reality of something that has happened in someone. The Bible is describing us, telling us that when we die, amen, things happen to some. Amen. Unbelievers are going to a place of torment. They are not dead completely yet. Because death in the Bible means eternal separation. If you die as a sinner, yes, you have already sealed your destiny this side. No remedy on the other side. But look what is happening here. The Bible is going to tell us. But Abraham said, amen, verse 25, son, remember that in your lifetime you received your good things and likewise Lazarus' evil things, but now he is comforted and you are tormented. And besides all this, between us and you, there is a great gulf fixed, a chasm. In other words, though you are the other side, you can't come to this side because you have already sealed your doom. No remedy, no chance to appeal. Hallelujah, my brother, my sister. This gospel is not for everybody. We preach as if everybody is going to be saved. We preach as if everybody is going to make it. We preach as if everybody is going to make the rapture. But let us also be aware, it is not for everybody. Our job is to pray for our loved ones. Testify to everybody that the grace of God is still available. Amen. As long as we are still here, as long as we are still breathing, there is an opportunity to everyone to embrace the gospel, plead for the grace of God, and be saved on his side, no matter how far we have gone into sin, no matter how far we have gone, amen, into unbelief. While we are still alive, there is an opportunity. The door of mercy is not closed. Don't you go and say that you have crossed the line of no return and that there is no chance for you. While we are still here, there is that opportunity. There is that opportunity to change, to be saved, to be forgiven, and to be redeemed. But once you cross that line of death and you die, that's it. A sinner. That's it. There's no, I will stand again and appeal. No way. Because there is a gulf. This message, my brother, is not one that is popular. This preaching is not one where you are looking for to get people worked up in the feelings. This is calling us to think of on our ways, to think on our relationship, to think of our walk with God. As I age, amen,
libraries. As we grow older, step by step, we begin to realize this life is temporary and we're not forever here. This life is not the real thing. Unless you know how to approach this life and prepare for what is coming after, you will be walking blindfolded. Whether it's through meetings, you go. Whether it's through music, you go. Whether it's through parties, you go. Everything taking place, you are carried away. And you're not thinking, is this right for me? Is this environment correct for my soul? The things that I'm feeding on is really conducive to my spiritual welfare. Salvation matters. Don't play with your salvation. No. I jealously fight for my salvation now, especially now, my brother. Amen. I guard my soul.
Amen.
Because I realize, amen, one tiny little mistake here on earth can cost me eternal life. And Jesus Christ clearly said, I'd rather you enter into heaven with one hunger, one eye, amen, than the whole of you to go down to hell.
Amen.
Oh, brother, you don't understand what the Bible is saying. Unless we don't believe this book, unless church is a club where we have fun, amen, good music, and we don't understand why we go to church, unless we are just a social club where every Sunday we come together and we hear good sermons. Hallelujah, sow your seed, and you sow your seed, and off you go. And the preaching is so popular, that's why we have wildfire in our churches of so-called miracles, amen, that are faked, amen, of witch doctors and witch pastors preaching the word of God behind in order to entice people. And Jesus Christ said, the blind leading the blind. And there are so many of them out there in churches and denominations looking for a quick miracle, which, hallelujah, does not result. On Friday, I don't know if you were watching on Friday, one brother sent me a message, I don't know who, where from, he said, that message should be uploaded on YouTube. Can you upload it? Because he says it was such a message that it just changed him. Of Jesus Christ and Mary, amen, and Martha, amen. Jesus Christ being the guest of honor. But here is Mary making sure that Jesus Christ is well looked after. What was she doing? It wasn't bad feeding someone. After all, Jesus was a guest of honor. Let's honor him. Amen. But Jesus Christ says, Mary has chosen that which cannot be taken away from her. Glory be to God. Why? Martha was, Jesus saying, you are troubled. You are worried about temporary stuff. And we are so worried about temporary stuff. Where am I going to be after here? Amen. Where am I going to build a house? Hallelujah. What about my children? What about the future? What about the school? What about my relationship? What about all these things? Of course, we have to plan. We have to think. We have to consider those things. But they are not, hallelujah, things that should keep us troubled. And we lose our focus on the Lord and make him our priority in everything. Jesus Christ, the Bible says, Mary sat at the feet of Jesus and she was hearing the word. She was hearing the word. Amen. While Martha was busy with earthly stuff. Ah, that's the church. You're just looking for blessings. Hallelujah. We're just looking for blessings. Amen. And after that, we go from blessing to blessing to blessing. And the Bible speaks about wildfire. Amen. But my brother, let's consider this scripture here of this man, Lazarus. Amen. He died. But there was a gulf. He couldn't come back. He was was in torment, the other side. Many are going that way. Who are they? Hallelujah! My God, help the church to believe and to change our ways. Help us, Father God.
Amen.
Revelation chapter 9. Oh, glory be to God. The Bible speaks, in those days, verse 6, men will seek death and will not find it. Can you just consider this? You will seek to die because death is an escape. It's better to die and forget about death. But the Bible says, in that day, people will seek to die but will not find it. They will desire to die and death will flee from them. You are, how can I, I'm looking to stay young. Sister, I'm looking to be fit and strong. I need to grow old. I don't want it. Amen. But I know death is coming. Death is there. Death is sitting in. But the Bible says, but I'm looking for, I'm running away from death. Amen. Now, but on that day, death, hallelujah, amen, will run away from us. We are looking to die for an escape, but death is not running away from us. Oh, brother. Amen. This is the old time Holy Ghost preaching. This is the old time preaching, my brother. Amen, 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 amen. We have escaped so much. We have in the gospel today, in our business churches today, it's just wildfire everywhere. Amen. Amen. It's just wildfire. Change heart. Amen. Be the Sunday of today. Praise be to God. A man who could just break the roof down by the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Where is the power of the Holy Spirit that fell on that day and shook the roof in Azusa Street? And they were speaking in tongues. Not a fake tongue that we are hearing today. But it was the real Holy Ghost of
Listen to what we're
on what I'm saying is, it might mean you're hearing the scripture. Your conception of what this question is may determine whether you walk out of that chair tonight, sir. It might be different between death, difference between death and life to many of you. Sinners, what decision of where you will spend eternity? The scripture plainly teaches, hallelujah, that man's opportunity for salvation is limited to the period of their earthly life. That decision is now. Is now. If a man dies unsaved, if a man dies unbelieving, their fate is death. Seriously, let's consider our ways. Proverbs 29, he who is often rebuked and hardens his neck will suddenly be destroyed, says the Bible, and thus without remedy. So if our hearts are hardened and we keep hardening in God, no remedy. There's going to be a group of people that's going to be marked for destiny in hell. And a group of people that's going to be marked for destiny in heaven. And I'm going to finish with this scripture here. Revelation chapter 11. I'll say 21, sorry. Amen. Verse 8. He who overcomes shall inherit all things, and I will be his God, he shall be my son. But the cowardly, unbelieving, abominable, murderers, amen, sexually immoral, sorcerers, idolaters, and all liars shall have their part in the lake of fire, which burns with fire and brimstone, which is the second death. That's the final destination for the sinner. What is awaiting for the sinner is not pleasant. One of these days, God is going to give you your final call. Then the door is going to be closed between mercy and judgment. Don't be left out. Don't be left out. Get in now while you can. Don't pay no attention what the word says. Get in as we stand. As we stand. Get in, my brother. How will you stand and support? Hallelujah. Think. I was coming and I saw this sign here on the entry. Think. Pause for a while. They say, think for a while. And they put this pause button. Hallelujah. Think. The sinners are going to spend time together with the idler of this world. The sinners will spend time in torment with the pharaohs of this world. Just think about it, Robert. Is the Bible telling us lies? Think of the sodomites. Think of those whose mind were constantly, the Bible says, thinking, imagining evil in the days of Noah. Think of being incarcerated forever with every blasphemer of this world. Just stop and think of those one who had
have nothing to do with God. But in the meantime, some of us, even with our churchianity, we still join them because we heard but did not apply. We heard but we did not consider these things. Where are we going to spend eternity? Oh, heaven and earth will pass away. Jesus, shake the church. Shake the church.
Amen.
Brother, when we first believed, the message was not like this. When we first came in contact with the message, brother, it was totally different. People were holy. We were praying right through the night. Non-stop. Amen. Of course, we had so many misunderstandings back then. But people were sincere. The sincerity, the fear of God was there. The fear of one another was there. But today, my brother, we have let down the bars. We have let down the bars. Amen. And the church has just become a name. Hallelujah. Where will you spend time with your soul? But the Bible says the blackness of darkness forever. Jude mentions. There won't be a respite. You know, a little respite, let me go for a little break. Because the torment is too much. There is no way to go for a little respite. We're so used to have sermons that make us jump. But we don't consider that the lake of fire is what awaiting the sinner, the liars, the warmongers, the fake and false pastors and ministries. Amen. No escape. Let's bow our heads. How can I resist the Holy Spirit? How can I resist His power? The final portion, amen, of the wicked will be, amen, beyond the creature's power of resistance. God is not going to care, hallelujah, how good you were here on earth. Have you received the Holy Spirit? Were you sealed here? Did you worship Him? We were worshiping here. You could feel the anointing. Oh, my brother. Oh, let's find a little song. Refiner's fire, brother. Amen. Hallelujah. The Bible clearly says, search me, O God. Search my heart. Try me. Search me. God needs to search you. Religion is not just verbal. Hallelujah. It is also searching your heart. Good team. How patient you are. How do you handle anxiety? How do you handle pressure? How do you handle pressure in your life, in your family, in your marriage, in your home, in your walk, at work? How do you manage? Do you get carried away because the pressure is too much as you are at a breakpoint? Amen. Do you bring it under the control of the Holy Spirit and do like what the Bible says, take your burden and cast it upon Him, roll it upon Him, trust and obey, for there is no other way. Amen. Glory be to God. Amen. Ready to do your
Jesus. Souls that are in prison, which the prophet so far regarded and he was so shaken. Because they have already seen their doom and their eternal destiny. And we realize, Father God, as we are still on this side of the Jordan, where we still have many opportunities. We don't want to waste every opportunity given to us to make right with you, Father. All the servants of God, all the servants, we have heard over the many years, which for some we disregard. We pray for your forgiveness. We pray for grace and mercy, Father. We pray, Father God, for your presence and divine intervention. We cry out to you, Father, mercy, 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 because you are full of grace, full of mercy, and full of compassion. Come, Lord Jesus, forgive us. For Father God letting down the bars. Forgive us. For Father God not considering seriously our ways. Forgive us. For not, Lord Jesus Christ, taking these things so seriously. Forgive us for just that religious mindset. Forgive us. Forgive us. Forgive us. Forgive us, Lord Jesus, for not giving you time to worship. For not giving you time to praise, for not giving you time, Father, in your word. The revival will not come, Lord Jesus, if we are casual. The revival will not come, Lord Jesus Christ, if we are not serious. Sincerity is not enough, because we can be sincere but all wrong. Father, it takes your Holy Spirit. We invite you. Our hearts are open. Oh, my heart is open. The church is open. West Spring is ready. We lay at the throne of God. We want to be your voice today. We want to be your witnesses, Lord. We want to be committed. We want to be dead seekers. We want to be ready. We want to be filled with the Holy Spirit. We want to be changed. We want to handle the word of God with care. Our walk, Lord Jesus, to display your words. Our lives, Lord Jesus, to be written epistles, read of all men. We want to have the testimony of Jesus. Pray like Jesus. Love like Jesus. Forgive like Jesus. Lord, Father, the example as you were, we want to be. Come, Lord Jesus. Shake each and every one of us today. As we leave this place, as we go home, Father, may your presence, Lord, never leave us, Lord. May we pause before we open, Lord Jesus Christ, as bottles. May we pause, Lord, before we light a cigarette. May we pause, Father God, before, Father God, we go into that illicit and evil action. May we pause, Father God, before we say the next lie. May we pause, Father God, before we do anything that will all grieve the Holy Spirit and consider, can this stop me from going forward? Can this stop me from reaching my goal? Can this hinder me from entering into the eternal destination of our life? When we miss, Lord Jesus Christ, the service, when we take your word, Lord God, lightly, can we, Father God, ponder over, Lord Jesus, the implication? I pray, Father, shake this little group here. We want to be the voice, Lord Jesus Christ, and that's going to shake the nation. We want to be the exalted, Father God, the church of Jesus Christ who was. The apostles, just a handful of them, but they shook the world. Come and fill this church. Come and baptize us with your Holy Spirit. So that, Father, when we are out we are supposed to run the battle, we will be fit and ready, Lord Jesus, to represent you and to be the people you intended that we should be, Father. Our testimony, Father, will be the testimony of Noah. Our testimony will be the testimony of Rahab. The past will be under the blood of the Lamb. The future secured because of the blood sprinkled over our lives. Have your way, Lord Jesus. Create in us a new heart. Create in us, Lord, new attitudes, new minds, and new thoughts. Oh God, new Lord Jesus passions, new Lord loves, new all five characters in each and every one of us. Oh God, that's the gospel will not just be something we talk about, but it will be, oh Father God, of real words of God. Father, those who are present, even those who couldn't make it, Father, we pray the same for them. Reach out and touch the Lord.
Reach out.
Reach.